You're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to radio. iLive Radio.
TalksHonest.
Hello, and welcome to TalksHonest. You are tuned into iLive Radio UK, changing the way you listen to radio. I'm your host, Miss Law, and joining me on today's show will be Miss Mode. This is a talk platform, an opportunity for you to express yourself and discuss topics never spoken of but often thought of. You can connect with us by contacting us on 0208 638 8503 or www.iliveradio.com/iLive-UK. Please come and get involved in our discussions.
What if we smoke honestly? What if we smoke honestly? What if we smoke honestly?
Reflection on 2019. I'd like to wish you all a happy new year and welcome to 2020. So we're into a new year. We're officially in 2020.
Brand new year.
Indeed. And upon reflection of 2019, how do you feel that year went?
There's been ups and downs for me, but more ups, which I'm thankful for. You know, obviously going into this year, I just want to kind of end off how I started the end of 2019 and just being more positive, doing things that I want to do, not necessarily relying on people for things. So my thing is, I like to go to gigs and events and stuff like that. But, you know, there's that kind of stigma of like, oh, you can't go on your own or anything like that. But I did accomplish that. I think it was back in July last year.
Okay.
And it felt great. I didn't feel like I was a Billy No Mates or anything like that. Because I know I was going there to see a favourite artist of mine and enjoy the music and the vibes and everything. So for 2020 this year, I'm hoping to go forward doing that. So any up and coming events coming, I'm just buying my ticket there and then. I'm not waiting for nobody. If you missed out, then that's your business, isn't it? But that's me. That's my thing for this year.
For my 2019, it's been an eventful one. I can say that all the goals that I set for myself, I have achieved and overachieved, which is good.
Yeah, that is, yeah.
So, upon reflection, it's been a good year.
Yeah.
2019 has been a really good year.
That's good.
And looking forward, like, yeah, good things to come.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah. I feel that I've achieved everything that I've set.
Mm-hmm.
And I just look forward to setting new goals.
Right.
I have done so much
mm-hmm.
in 2019, and it's like, wow, I'm looking back and thinking, okay, tick, 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 tick.
Yeah.
And I think it's a nice feeling yeah. to have set goals for yourself, and you can look in that book or look on your phone and say, okay, yeah, that's been done.
Yeah, you achieved that, yeah.
And sometimes when you achieve them before you had anticipated yeah. you would or had set the goal to,
mm-hmm.
is another additional achievement.
That's right, yeah.
So, yeah, 2019's been good to me. Mm-hmm. Health-wise, maybe not.
Mm-hmm.
But upon reflection now, I'm good.
So it's not necessarily like worse maybe 2-3 years ago, it's probably going in the right direction, and if you have stumbled, you know where to fix up.
Exactly. Yeah. I can identify where things
went wrong
and I can pinpoint what I need to do
and how to avoid
that happening again. But you know, life is like that though. It's up and down.
Well, that's it. It's never straightforward.
Never.
Yeah.
And if it was, you'd question that anyway.
Exactly.
You'd be like, well, it can't be that perfect, right?
Right. So what's going on here?
So for you, were there any obstacles along your way?
I think there was when it came to dealing with friendships, dealing with myself and my self-care.
Okay.
And yeah, just my journey through healthy eating and stuff like that. Like, the basics is always still there, but my thing is now I'm trying to, I know you said previously you're trying to be a vegan, I'm trying to go down that route. I think sometime early last month, or was it late November, I did have a cheese and onion pasty, but my love for cheese has kind of gone down more than what it was before. So I don't miss it as how I used to.
As much as you used to have
it. So I feel like I'm in the right direction, but sometimes for me, I just get that urge to have a bit of cheese.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, I must say, with regards to you talking about cheese and... I used to love cheese.
Yeah.
But it's, and I used to love eggs.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't have either now.
Yeah.
And it's quite weird, like, when you said what you just said, like, about the cheese, it's like, kind of, for a split second, it was like, oh, cheese. I mean, it was like, oh, it's gone.
Yeah.
It was like a puff of air.
Yeah.
And it's gone.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's... It's quite interesting that
those little things
that you liked.
But it's like I'm not craving.
You're not craving.
It's just that moment at that time I wanted it.
Yeah.
But then I won't have it for months. Where before I would have it more regular, but now I feel that I don't.
You don't need it.
Need it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's an interesting journey that transitioning over from one to another food.
Yeah. And then I think, with like friends and friendships and stuff like that, for me, and I'm just only talking from my experience, because I'm a person who never had loads of friends, having less of them now, it doesn't bother me at all. I'm just like, what it is, isn't it? There's a reason and a season for everything. So I would say that I'm in a good space right now, and not saying that there's going to be obstacles ahead of me, but for now I'm in the right, going in the right direction. Where I am and what I do, what I've been doing for the last, you know, what, 6 months
or something
like that, I'm very happy in that situation I'm in now, so I'm very thankful for that. My thing is legacy.
Okay.
My thing is not to make the most money in the whole wide world and stuff like that. My thing is to make an impact, whether it's on my own life or someone else's.
Yeah, most definitely.
That's where my head is kind of focused now. Yeah.
For me, there have been obstacles. And I think when you venture into anything, there are always obstacles. It's just how you overcome them.
Mm-hmm.
Some obstacles are not necessarily negative.
Yeah.
There can be learning curves for you. So, because obviously we all have a perception of whatever we're going to do.
Mm-hmm.
Our perception isn't necessarily what it is.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not until you enter into something, then you realize, oh, my perception is not the way that it's actually worked out.
Mm-hmm.
So even though we make set goals and challenges for ourselves, we're learning in the process.
Yeah.
So we get it, we step into something, we start to do it, then it branches off here and it branches off there. And before you know it, you know, you're just you're learning while you're trying to take that step.
Yeah.
So obstacles are expected. I mean, I've had a few, but I didn't take them as a negative.
Mm-hmm.
I took them as, okay, my process of how I thought it would have gone isn't the way it would have gone,
mm-hmm.
or was going to go.
Yeah.
So yeah, it kind of taught me something.
Oh.
And I think that's important as well.
It is, yeah.
Because sometimes you just think it is the way you think it is. And then you conversate with someone and then they tell you something and you have a different spin on it.
Yeah.
So yeah, obstacles, yeah, there have been some. And I can hand on heart say, yeah, they've overcome. I don't feel like, oh my God, I should have done it this way. I've just learned along the way.
I think that's how you process it now and how your mindset reacts to something that has kind of blocked you temporary.
Yes.
So you would know how to sort it, whether it takes you picking it apart and going like layers. And then rebuild.
Because you have to dissect it, don't you, at the end of the day?
Yeah.
So that you can actually understand what is actually happening.
Then just like, oh, well, I failed this now, so that's it for the rest of the year. I'm just going to be failing everything.
No, but like, you can't think like that.
Think like,
no.
Yeah.
Because then you would never achieve anything, would
that's
you?
That's right, yeah.
Another thing that I had thought about was the ups and downs of, you know, my challenges for the year and how that affected me and how I dealt with those kind of things. Thankfully, there weren't too many downs. However, there were some. And overall, I think I managed to cope with them as best I can.
Mm-hmm.
And just understanding why there were ups and downs kind of helped to get me through.
Mm-hmm.
Because obviously nothing is ever just straightforward, is it?
No, it's not.
So when we go to do something, it's as though we're not expecting to be any downs.
Yeah.
Because we're not being realistic about what we're venturing into.
That's right, yeah.
So for me, yeah, ups and downs are good because they challenge your mind.
Yeah, and it, I think as we get older, it makes us look at it a different way.
Yeah, most definitely.
Like, from before, we would just, as I said, we'll just be like, okay, done. But we learn how to process it a different way. So going forward, it may happen again.
Yeah, but then we process it differently.
Right, and we would know how to get back on track.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This subject's it's different for everyone.
Oh, yeah.
The experience, the challenges, the goals, they all differ for every one of us. And we put certain things into perspective and certain things are still a work in progress. So just backtracking a bit. Christmas, how was Christmas for you? Because that was coming towards the end of the year and, you know, that's like the final chapter.
Yeah, Christmas was good, actually. I really had a really good time. Cooked a really nice meal. Everybody was happy with that. So it was just nice. And it was nice to get away. Nice to get a break from London and just be away from all the hustle and bustle and the rushing around and just be somewhere where it's just nice and quiet.
And calm.
Calm, not much going on. I can wake up in the morning, I'm not hearing any like noises or anything like that. It was just nice. It was really nice and it gave me time to, it was like a form of meditation being away from London as well.
I find that is the case. When you leave London, it's like a refresh.
Yeah.
Like you've been restart
all year. And then it's like you take a break away from London, or even if it's not going abroad or you're just going just outside of London, wherever. And it just feels like, breath of fresh air. You feel relaxed. There's no work. There's nothing that you need to do. You just get up when you feel like it. Go to bed when you feel like it. And you just wake up feeling nice. Like, so for me, I've been getting up at a decent time in the morning.
Yeah.
Meditating.
Wonderful.
Yeah, meditating for like an hour, 45 minutes to an hour. And that's really helped.
Is that something you were doing throughout the year?
Not regular.
Started to do towards the end of the year?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I've noticed that's helped me a lot. So
when you say it's helped you, what, your mindset or just your overall being?
In general, my whole being as well. Just being more relaxed, not being so tensed up, not to be all stressed out about things. Just whatever it is, you know. If I can fix it there and then yeah. But if not, so be it. And I've been going out for walks in the morning as well. Yeah, I used to do it here back in London, but I stopped.
Okay.
I used to go out early in the morning, walk. I'm not going to say where I live, but
naturally.
But it was a good distance and walked all the way back. Even though I had my Oyster card on me just in case, I was a bit tired. But yeah, but then I done it where I went for my Christmas break.
Oh, wonderful! And, but yeah, that must have been completely different then.
Yeah, because it was, you got hills, you got greenery, just there, and it's just like, oh, I wish I could do this every day. Like, why couldn't I be near this?
So what was for dinner?
It was like a vegan thing.
Oh, wonderful.
I did like these little callaloo fritters things. I did like a mixed fried veg. I attempted to do like a vegan macaroni pie but using the spelt pasta.
Excellent.
Doing the vegan cheese. So that was interesting. It was nice. It was nice. Like, it's different, but it tastes nice. I enjoyed it. Yeah. Obviously, who I was staying with, they made their meat and stuff like that and done the roast potatoes, etc.
Yeah.
But done a nice, like, Mediterranean type salad. So that was nice with loads of avocado. So I love my avocado.
Oh, wow. Making me hungry. Yeah.
So yeah, it was nice. It was really nice. Had her friends come over. They know me as well. So that was nice. And it was just like proper relaxation.
Yeah, appreciate
for me. So it's like coming back now, I'm refreshed, I'm ready to go. Whatever's in store for me, I'm ready for it, you know what I mean? And I'm thinking maybe I need to take breaks more often.
Just maybe, to refresh the mind.
Like every few months or something, just take a break.
Yeah. It's funny, like, because just leaving London just feels like a break.
Yeah.
It could just be a day away.
Yeah.
And that alone, just your mindset is just like, you kind of like clear out.
That's right.
And then like you
shut down.
Shut down, literally.
Literally. And it's just like, oh my gosh. It's just all peace and calm.
Yeah.
I don't have to worry about anything, and it's just like, it's just so nice.
Yeah, and it's funny that we have to come out of our environment to actually appreciate that.
Yeah,
because everyone says the same thing.
They
it's
do.
Like, oh, I need a break. Automatically, they feel stress, tension. I need a break.
Yeah.
You take the break, and then it's like, oh my god, I so needed that.
Yeah.
Oh, thank god I had that, and then it happens again.
That's right.
And they go for the same cycle again.
Yeah.
It's weird.
It is. But how about you? How was your Christmas?
Oh, wow. Mine was awesome. Yeah. Sunshine.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. With the family. A small percentage of the family.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Great food. Everything you can think of.
Nice.
Food in the cooking. We all did it.
Oh, you all chipped in.
Yeah,
nice.
Everyone done their little thing. Yeah, always food in abundance as usual.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you know, it's like, oh, have we done this and have we done that? And what about this and what about that? And before you know, you got like 15 dishes on the table.
On the table,
like,
already, yeah.
And you're like, where's the space to put it? For more, you know, and the thing is, the build up to Christmas is like, okay, prep.
Yeah.
And then you get to that point where you see the food and you just see the table filling up, and you're thinking, I'm not even hungry.
Yeah,
I'm not even hungry.
There's more.
And there's more in the oven, and there's more. There's dessert, there's cakes. And not to mention you've had breakfast, because you've woken up late.
Yeah, late.
So you know the time span between dinner and breakfast is shortened, and it's like, oh my God, I need to build up an appetite.
Appetite for that, yeah.
And then you end up eating Christmas dinner late.
Later, yeah.
But overall, it was a good Christmas.
That's good.
Yeah, I mean, being in the sun makes such a big difference.
Oh, yeah.
The dynamic's different, mm-hmm. You know, you're pleasant inside, you're feeling pleasant, you're feeling happy, mm-hmm. and just overall, it was good.
That's good. That's
Really good. I do like my sunny Christmases.
Yeah. If you can do it, then do it.
Yeah. And
definitely.
I was stuffed after it all. Just like, you know, you just get to that point where siesta time. It's
I'm just going to sit here.
Yeah, right. As kicks you know, in, just like you're just floated off. Yeah. And you wake up hungry again, ready for part two, part three, part four, and so on. And those who indulge in alcohol, they're out for the count.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
But yeah, it was a good Christmas.
Oh, brilliant. Yeah. That's really good.
And upward and onwards for, you know, 2020.
Yeah, definitely. So yeah.
What does it hold? You know, setting new goals.
Yeah.
Setting new achievements, you know, business, you know, ventures. Mm. So, yeah. It's just forward thinking now.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to this year.
Yeah, the relaxation was good.
Yeah.
That downtime.
Yeah.
Is something that's so needed. And like you said, like waking up, not having to be waiting for an alarm clock to wake you up, you know, just waking up naturally.
And then you just taking your time, whether you just walk into the kitchen to make yourself a hot drink or something, and you just relax. You're just I don't need to do nothing today. Like, I would say the Monday, I'm thinking, oh, I got to come here.
Yeah.
No, I'm not. I mean, I'm not even in London. What am I talking about?
But
because you're in that program, aren't you?
Yeah.
And program that way. That's what I was there thinking for that few days. But I think after that Christmas and then being going out, doing the shopping to buy the food and stuff like that and the prepping, then I'm like, yeah, I'm not in London no more. Yes.
Yeah.
I can officially relax now.
Yeah.
Had the music blasting out. I was playing the music. Like, my godmother doesn't know some of the music, but she was like, oh, she's enjoying it. That was good.
That's, you know, upon reflection, when you think about these things and you take that time away and you sit down, it puts a smile on your face.
It does.
Because, you know, no matter what happened up to that point, be it good or bad,
mm-hmm.
that last moment that you had within the year, if it's important and if it was good for you, then it stays with you, doesn't it?
It does.
So, but yeah, it's nice. I hope that everyone else had a nice Christmas.
Yeah, really.
And and ate a bit, was merry.
Or whatever you was doing. Hope you had a good time off to just relax and reflect.
Some downtime.
Yeah, definitely,
I hope everyone had that. So, we spoke about Christmas Day, like the food and all that stuff. How was it leading up to that point?
Well, it kind of started in November, because obviously I knew I was going up there to spend Christmas and New Year. I asked my godmother, like, what do you want, like, down here? Because even though they have the Caribbean food up there, when I went there the last time, they don't have a lot like how we have it here in London. So I was like, do you want breadfruit? What do you want? Do you want pumpkin? What do you want? And she's like, well, you can get me some pumpkin if you want. So I said, all right, I'll get you two whole breadfruits. I said, what about the pumpkin? No, we have pumpkin here. And I'm like, well, yeah, but your pumpkins ain't looking all that to me when I was there the last time. So I'm like, all right then, well, whatever you want to get. So I'm like, all right, I'm going to get the pumpkin as well.
Okay.
Get the cho-cho. I said I'm going to get some saltfish as well.
Oh, wicked.
And I was like, cake. Should I order a cake? Because the bakery shop in Dalston, who are from St. Lucia, they make really good cakes and stuff like that there. And I've been going to them from since I was young. My mum used to go there. So she's like, all right then, yeah, get a cake. So I'm like, all right, I'll put the order in. So I did that the first week in December.
Wow.
Yeah. But I wanted to collect it on the day I was going.
Right.
So went there in the morning, collected that, went and got all the other bits. And yeah, obviously I had to come studio to do my last show of the year as well.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, so I got some of the bits here, but then when I went up to Leicester now, it was the next day Monday, yeah, that's when we started to get all the other bits and pieces in.
Wow.
So yeah,
it's been an eventful one.
Yeah, because I even asked her before, like, you got Costco in Leicester, right? And she's like, yeah. And I was like, okay, I've got a card. So she's like, oh, I've got a card as well. I was like, okay, we're going Costco.
Excellent.
So I got a tray of croissants.
Oh, excellent.
Because I always had that for like breakfast in the morning.
Yeah, yeah.
So got that and, you know, drinks and stuff like that. So yeah, it was good. And because she drives as well, so that was helpful.
That helpful
so
as well, yeah.
We just drove all over the place.
Wow, yeah. Wow.
Yeah, so yeah. And then I would say, leading up to that, Christmas Eve, no, the day before Christmas Eve. So yeah, we started to prep. All by now we had a rough idea of what we were going to be doing.
Yeah,
I knew what I was doing on my part, she knew what she was doing on her.
Yeah.
So we was just doing our own thing. I wasn't trying to meddle in what she's doing. That's your section.
This is my section.
Yeah. And get it out of the way.
Hard at it.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So then, like, yeah, Christmas morning, we had breakfast. I made saltfish and fried dumpling.
Nice.
Yeah, and had my, you know, hot drink and stuff like that. And we just chilled. And then, yeah, for Christmas Eve, it was more or less the prepping. Didn't want to eat too much.
Because obviously we're trying
to wait for the big day, you know, because we had other people coming.
But you know, well, Christmas Eve is testing time.
Oh, yeah, it is. Yeah,
you know, you've got to make sure things taste all right, right?
Yeah, definitely.
That's your excuse to eat.
So, yeah, doing that. And then the big day, and, you know, I was up early. You know, just more or less taking my time, you know, because we'd done the prep the night before, so it wasn't really much to do, because obviously turkey's going in the oven.
Was there a lot of you?
Yeah, there was. There was, because some of her friends who knew me as well, but because they haven't seen me for a long time, they came over, so that was nice.
Okay.
To catch up with them and stuff like that. And yeah, it was an eventful night. As I said, music playing, you know, me being my silly self, dancing, doing my thing.
Everyone mingling.
And everybody mingling, just everybody chatting, drinking. You know, it was nice. Yeah. It was really nice. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, for me, leading up to Christmas, it was quiet. Because I don't particularly like all that mad mayhem, that rushing around, doing things.
Yeah.
I'm more the type of person who will go online, order my stuff, it gets delivered, and I do that over the year, leading up to maybe, usually by the end of October, I've got all my presents.
Right, yeah.
And then I've just got like a big sack, or they get hidden different parts of the house.
Oh, yeah.
And then Christmas Eve, everything gets pulled out.
Oh, right.
So I wasn't sure whether I was going to travel or not. So it was, am I traveling, am I not traveling, because flights are well expensive.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was umming and ahhing as to, am I going to be traveling, am I going to travel. So it transpired that I did travel.
Yeah.
So that whole thing about Christmas presents and stuff like that was like, am I going to be doing Christmas presents or not? Because obviously I'm in the event that I travel, it won't be a Christmas present thing because I won't be here to do Christmas presents. Yeah. So for me, it wasn't the norm, because obviously the build up to Christmas is you're doing the shopping and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But I had got what I needed to get in the event I travel. Right.
Yeah.
Obviously, the Christmas cards and, you know, small presents, you know, just for someone to have, for them to have when Christmas Day arises.
Yeah, yeah.
But overall, it was great.
Good.
Yeah, it was, as you know, the Christmas Eve, like you were saying, you know, the prepping, the tasting, the testing, you know, we become professional testers when it comes to Christmas Eve.
Because we're chefs, you know.
We're chefs and we're a la carte and we're non-a la carte and, you know, and you just find yourself just taking, you're in Christmas Eve, before you know it, you're in Christmas Day. And you're like, oh, we need to go to sleep.
Yeah.
But overall, like, the being in the sun, just waking up to the sun blaring through the window.
It's just warm. Weather's just nice.
It's just a nice feeling. You know, sitting on the veranda having breakfast.
Yeah.
As opposed to being stuck in London.
Yeah.
With closed doors, you know, you can't open the windows, you can't open the door because it's too cold, you know, and it's like, it's a flip side of the coin because it's like, it's just so nice to just be sitting there and not in a jumper or cardigan, just little strap top.
Little
bird tweeting
nice
in the background.
Maxi dress on, just relax, sandals and all that. You can't.
But
that.
When it came to the food, we did food across the board. You name it, it was there.
It was there.
Fresh salmon.
Yeah. And when it's fresh, that is fresh.
Yeah. So, you know, it's like, it's just yummy.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of like lost for words because, you know, like when it comes to food, it's like you kind of, when it comes to Christmas, you're just so... like look forward to it, didn't you?
Yeah, you do.
To the point that sometimes you're not even hungry.
No.
You know, at the time that you have your Christmas dinner, sometimes like you just sit down with the family to have your meal. But you're really not hungry.
Mm-hmm. It's true.
And then you're like, you're just eating because you just want to be with the family. And then you like have a small plate and then you're like 2 hours later, you're back at the table again. But then there's another family member at the table again. And it's like, but that whole eating thing is so nice.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Because when you think about it, in the year, you don't do that, do you?
No, you don't.
So it's like, it's something you look forward to. When it's there, it's like, you don't want it to end.
You don't. You really don't.
You really don't want it to end. And it's like, oh my God, like, you're looking at the clock and it's like, Don't finish, please. Because I'm going to sever this moment.
Yeah.
I want this to be here for like 48 hours, not 24, kind of thing. Because you already slept through about 5 hours anyway.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So you kind of missed part of the day already. Yeah.
And thankfully you're up before the day started. So it's like, okay. Yeah. But overall, Christmas has been good.
That's good.
Yeah, it has been a good one. If you want to get involved in the conversation, you can contact us on 0208-638-8503 or www.uk.i-liveradio.com.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling
So going back to what we were saying, so was there anything that you can think in 2019 that kind of jumped out at you when you reflected on 2019?
I think one of the things was the finding a studio for iLiveUK. Obviously, that was a big process.
Yeah, that's a big task.
Of looking for somewhere suitable, because you have to look at it logistically when you're looking for a space. It had to cover certain things, so obviously it had to cover transport for people who may be traveling from far, that they know that there's buses or underground stations that they can get on, that is accessible to them, that can get them from wherever they're coming from.
Yeah.
Also, it had to be nearby for the station manager, so if there is a problem. It's not far to travel to go to. So I can't even tell you how many viewings we've been on, and the type of studio spaces that we came across. Like, if you
it's a learning curve, isn't it?
It was very interesting. I've learned a lot.
I could imagine
about looking for spaces space. And that it has to follow certain criteria of like the space size we need, the budget that we had, and the area as well. So we went to so many studios and it was like, nope, this has potential. Then it's like, nope. Eventually it was a no.
And weren't ticking all the boxes.
And then I just remember one day me and DJ Jarzino, we went to a viewing in Angel. And this space, all right, it might be good for whoever else, but the way you had to get through it was like you was in a crystal maze or something. It was like, well, not even a crystal maze, just a maze itself. Like, you had to go through here, go up there, go through here, go down here, go out there. I'm like, when I think about it now, I'm like, no one would...
No one would be able to find it.
No one would be able to find it or even bother coming back.
They have to do arrows.
Yeah, saying, this way to highlight you. And then when we finally got there, it was an open plan. And I'm like, but that's not a studio, because you've got all these people with their artwork. So you're trying to say, I must do what I'm trying to do.
Oh, so you're saying, it was just open space with numerous different...
Yeah, I would think it wasn't... You had to kind of build...
A wall. A barrier.
Just
to barricade yourself in.
Yeah, so I'm like... No. So that day, like, me and Jardina, we're just like, you know what, let's go and get something to eat. So we grabbed something to eat. And I was like, what about... The other studio we was gonna look at, maybe we can go down there and find out what's the latest with the development of that new space that they told us. So we went down there, spoke to someone there as well, telling us, what was been going on. So it was a refurbishment they were doing.
Okay.
But it wouldn't have been ready until November. They said November in 2018.
Right.
So I'm like, okay. All right, so we'll wait a bit. But we still looked at other places. But then going into 2019 now, we're still waiting. So we're thinking, what's going on? Then we got the message saying we can actually come and view it.
Oh, right, okay.
It's not fully complete, but it will give you an idea of this studio. An idea of what your space will look like. So I'm like, okay, great. So we went to the studio. It was based in North London, and the area was perfect. It's gonna be accessible to everybody.
Okay.
Plus there was free parking. Okay. So
that was a no-brainer.
That was a no-brainer.
Yeah.
So went in there, checked it out, looked at the space. The space was very decent, because according to how the station is in Toronto, this space is much more bigger.
Right.
So I was like, okay, cool. So we had, you know, many views again, because obviously we had to watch it being built and see where they were putting things, how it was going to be set up.
Yeah.
So we've been back a few times and went there and, yeah, we liked the space. And it was, we was then in there trying to figure out, well, where are we going to put the office part and the reception bit?
Yeah.
How are we going to do the actual studio itself or the station? And yeah, and then that's when
you can see it all coming together.
And that's how the process came into play, like it was real now.
Yeah.
It's actually happening. So, you know, everybody who could helped out, built the studio. And, you know, even now I'm in the studio now and I'm looking at it and I'm like, every time I come here, I'm in amazement.
Yeah. So
how it was
to start
and the
with.
The thing is, I took videos of everything.
Yeah.
So it's like when you look at past videos and you've been like, you're looking at the phone, you're looking in here, like,
yeah.
You did. So it was like this and now it's like this. Like,
yeah. It's quite an achievement, isn't it?
It's a massive...
Because you've gone from a shell...
I've never, ever done anything like this.
Yeah.
Because I just come from an office back.
Yeah.
I don't know about... Structure and...
Yeah, walls. You know,
looking for studios of this size.
Yeah. Just looking for studios in general, right?
Yeah. That's not my thing.
Yeah.
But it's something that I enjoy doing. I learned a lot from that,
mm-hmm.
and that's given me knowledge now to make me feel confident. Oh, I know what to look for if I'm looking for a studio or space or something. I know once I've got the logistics down of what's required,
then you know then what I kind know of space you're looking for.
Right. Yeah. So with that, getting the studio all set up, and then obviously we had our soft launch in April last year.
Yes.
And like that was just amazing itself.
Yeah,
like,
it was awesome.
I'm like, wow, like look what we've done.
Yeah, it was quite pleasing to see how it was all structured, how what we had in written on paper was actually executed so well.
Yeah.
And everything was on point.
Yeah. It was.
You know, it made you feel proud.
It did, and it still does.
Yes, it did.
Because
and it does. You're correct.
Every time I come in here, I get a good feeling. I feel nice because it was us who
built it to what it is right now.
To what it is. We took our time as such to build this.
Yeah.
This is ours, you know?
From the ground up.
Literally, yeah. And just to see what we've achieved and...
Yeah, in a time span.
Sometimes I'm just lost for words.
Yeah, it's quite emotional because it's, you know, as much as I wasn't in the country when everything, I was sent pictures constantly and like seeing what it was. Yeah. And then coming here and then being amongst you guys and you guys telling me stories about, you know, this wasn't there and that wasn't there there was just this there. And it's like, it made me feel a little bit like, oh, I wish I was there.
Yeah.
You know, I did say that.
No, like, I know, because I think like, you would have loved the experience of being there physically.
But the mere fact that you guys kept me connected with the point where I was getting photographs every day when you guys were doing stuff, I was,
even though I wasn't there physically, I was there.
Yeah. So, but it kind of, for me, it was like, I wanted to be here.
Yeah.
You know, and I think for me, it was like, when I came, I just wanted to do all I could do just to say, well, I know I wasn't here in the beginning,
but
I'm here now, and let me just do what I can do to put my stamp on it. Because when I came, I was just like wowed. it had the major wow factor.
It did.
I've never been in a studio before, well, to set a radio station,
not
other than visiting as a guest.
Yeah.
But you don't look at the dynamics of the studio like that. You're just going to be interviewed. You're going to be interviewed, and that's all that matters.
Yeah.
So to know that we have built this to what it is today, and it's amazing.
It is. It is.
And you know, it's not because it's ours.
Mm-hmm.
It's because when I look at every corner of this place,
mm-hmm.
I know we did it.
Yeah.
You know, and I think that's the most important thing.
It is.
It's our baby.
Yeah.
And we didn't get contractors in to come and do anything. Nope. We didn't get anyone to come in and fix this. We fixed, we've built, we've painted, you name it, we've done it all.
I see.
And that's a major achievement.
It really is. Like, and it took hard work and
dedication, coming in
every day. Yeah. I don't, at that time there was no day off.
Yeah,
it was straight coming in early in the morning, finishing late.
Yeah.
When it came to the weekends, now it was like weekend was a myth. Like, you was just
didn't know what day it was.
It's just like you worked until you just couldn't work no more. There was a time where big up to MacGyver and Jarzino's cousin, we had a little break on a Saturday and the weather was warm, and we all went to get chicken and stuff and done like a little barbecue.
Oh, wicked.
So that was nice, and I captured that on video as well. Yeah. So that's something where
it's great memories.
When it comes to our anniversary, it'd be nice to include that in with all the other videos that was taken.
Yeah.
Just to see where we started
and where we're at
and where we're at now and where we're going.
Yeah.
You know,
it would be nice to have a an album.
Yeah.
Do a photo, an iLive photo album.
Yeah, and make it be like a continuous one.
Yeah.
So where it's ended, to be continued, and then follow it on.
Yeah, most definitely.
It's just amazing. Like, I mean, now, like, listeners, I'm just looking around and I'm just like,
yeah,
I'm
admiring.
Just like very proud.
Yeah.
I'm very proud.
And we have reason to be proud.
Yeah.
Because it's quite an achievement.
It is.
And the thing that makes it even nicer is the fact that when people come in, how they feel about the space.
Oh, yeah, they look at it like, oh, wow, this place is, as they say, lit, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, and
so
it's nice
to hear that. And that's not
us saying that. That's other people
walking in and seeing it, and they're just saying it. Just out loud,
yeah. It's like they're thinking it and it just comes out.
It just comes out.
Yeah. It's quite funny because it's like so many people have just like been like, wow.
Yeah, that's
this is great.
Yeah.
This is like, they want to take pictures in here.
Yeah.
They want to take pictures by the...
Oh, yeah, they want to get on their Insta and, you know, start videoing and taking pictures and posting it up, which is a good thing.
Yeah.
It's a good thing, yeah. So I'm very proud. I'm very proud of this place. I'm very proud of
the achievement
and everyone who done the hard work and took the time out of their busy schedule to help, whether it was very small or big, whatever. I'm just happy that we've done this. And, you know, obviously going on forward, we had the soft launch in April, and then we had the official launch in August, if I'm correct.
Yes.
Yeah, we had the...
Yeah, I think it was August,
And that was an amazing...
That was awesome.
Because obviously you was here now.
Yeah.
So you was here to see that now.
See it in its entirety.
And that was big.
Yeah.
Like the amount of people that turned up.
Yeah, that was really a heartfelt achievement. Because one, we hadn't done it before, because we didn't have a radio station.
Yeah, yeah.
We now have a radio station that we could show to people.
Yeah.
Then we had to entertain these people, and everyone's perception of us as a team was just you guys are so professional.
It was spot on.
You guys are so pleasant. You're interacting. You know, the feedback was just phenomenal.
It was.
It felt good to know that we were part of something that
that we did
and that people really do like.
Yeah.
Because remember, we've only just put ourselves on the map in
That's
the UK.
Right. Yeah.
So
exactly.
For us, we don't know how we're going to be received. But one thing we did know is that we weren't going to do it by half measures.
Oh no, definitely. We were professional.
Yeah,
from start to finish,
and there's more to
continue.
Come.
Continue.
You know.
Yeah.
So when you look at that, it's quite emotional.
It is. It really is. Because it was like when we were all had to be called up for the, you know, the iLiveUK team to, you know, stand all together, and I'm like, wow.
Because even though you're called up, you don't see it in that light.
And then for me, I'm behind the scenes type of person.
Me
I'm
too.
Not that.
No.
I'm not that type of being in front and all that. So even when they did call us, I still was behind.
Yeah, I remember because I was like all the way down the front of the building.
Yeah.
Like, oh gosh.
Yeah.
And there was just like plonk there, like.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's been so far with our radio station, it has been a great experience.
Yeah. I'm loving the journey. I'm not going to lie. And I'm not just saying that. I'm actually loving the journey. As I said, the official launch was amazing. Great speeches by both the CEO, DJ Sessions, and DJ Jarzino. Just amazing. Like I did feel a bit, you know,
emotional.
Like,
it was emotional.
Yeah, it was.
Because to go from nothing to all of this in such a short space of time and really put ourselves on the map.
Yeah, because I just remember before, like, oh, when's it? Have you found the studio yet?
Yeah,
no.
Meetings leading up.
Yeah.
And I think when a lot of people didn't see the vision.
Yeah.
And they didn't have that hope.
Yeah.
And understanding that this was going to happen.
Yeah.
And I think upon coming here and physically seeing it, and I mean, even the way that we executed the launch, that was like, Those people who weren't sure, who were in the team, definitely were sure.
Oh,
at
definitely. Yeah, that made them just change their whole view of it.
Yeah,
they're like, oh yeah,
wow,
oh, wow, like
most definitely. Yeah, wow. You know, it's kind of caught me, that one.
Yeah,
because I'm feeling pretty emotional.
It does.
But that's been quite a major achievement for us this year.
Yeah, it has.
You know, when I think back to for 2019, it's like this one just sticks right out.
It does.
You know, nothing else, because we've really put our time and energy into this.
Yeah,
and wholeheartedly focused on just making this phenomenal.
Yeah.
And we have achieved
and
overachieved.
That's right.
And you know, as much as we're doing what we're doing, we have to commend ourselves for the hard work and dedication that we've all put in to getting it to where it is right now.
Yeah.
Our brand is strong.
It really is. It really is. And we've got a strong team.
Yes, most definitely.
Yeah.
But 2019 for us is really iLiveUK.
That was the major highlight of 2019.
Yeah, most definitely,
hands down.
And not to mention, what about the event we had at Hideaway? That's another thing. Yeah, our Soulfest.
Our very first.
That's right.
Soulfest Lounge. After
the launch.
The launch, like. Yeah. We were really on the roll, isn't it?
Right,
definitely.
We
was proper putting a stamp, like, we're here now.
We've landed.
Yeah.
You see us or you don't see us,
you're going to see us.
You're going to see us, because we're making you know that we've landed.
Yeah.
So it was like one thing after another.
Yeah.
And then we just came down.
Yeah.
And we could reflect on everything. I mean, Hideaway, that show was...
I think the whole
process of preparing for that and getting the artists and stuff like that, it was just amazing. Like, because I've never done anything like that, going down that route of organizing artists to come and play at a venue. That's never been my thing. But again, I learned a lot from that. I've learned so much from that, you know, the build up to it, doing the interviews with the artists and stuff, the promotion of it, because I've never done so much promoting in my life. So that was really good, just promoting and just getting people to come to this event, because you're not gonna be disappointed, you're gonna enjoy it.
Yes, it was quite an interesting and also an emotional time, because we've been a part of putting on other shows, but this was our show. And this was a reflection of iLiveUK.
Okay, so this was us.
Yeah, and then this had our name against it.
Yeah, so we know we had to be more than professional. Like, we were trying to be more than what we did for our launch.
And I think the one thing upon reflection of that is we're a certain kind of people.
Yeah.
And when we're executing anything, we're not doing it at 50%. We're not doing it 100%. We're doing it at 200%.
Oh, yeah.
Because whatever we do is a reflection of us.
Yeah.
And our brand.
Ah.
So, therefore, if you see us once, you know what you're getting.
Yeah.
Across the board.
That's right. Yeah.
And for me, it speaks in volumes.
Yeah. It does. The whole organizing, the, you know, the meetings and, you know, everybody knowing their position and knowing what they're doing on the night of the event. Me, to be honest, I was nervous.
Oh, of course.
I was nervous.
I mean,
I was nervous because I'm thinking, okay, so my role was to manage the floor, so I had to be everywhere and make sure everybody's good and whatnot. And I'm like, I've never done this. All I've done is sat at a desk and typed letters or whatever, and that's it. This
is a new, something completely
different,
out of your comfort zone.
Yeah, so I mean, but it was like, once I was there and I was in my Soulfest t-shirt, so I'm like, yes, I'm official now.
Yeah.
And dress, everybody looked so amazing, smart, in uniform. Loved that. And then obviously the show went on nicely, the DJs were amazing, the artists were super
phenomenal.
Like, oh my gosh, so amazing. And then just checking on everyone, making sure everyone's all right, and just me looking at the crowd and how they're just engaging with the artists they are, and they're singing along, some of them getting up and
dancing.
I was like,
wow.
Like,
yeah.
I kind of stepped out and thought, I'm someone who's come here for the show, not the person who is one of the people who are part of organizing this show.
Yeah.
So I'm like, wow. We did that.
Yeah.
We all did that.
Most definitely.
And it's like, I had to take pictures with the people who came to see the artist with our cassette.
Yeah, our cassette, our logo cassette.
And it's like, everyone I was going to, they said, oh, I had such a great time. It was amazing night.
Amazing feedback.
You guys were so professional. Like, there was no problem. Everything went to plan.
Yeah.
There was no hiccups or anything like that. And I'm like, that's iLiveUK, man.
Yeah.
That is iLiveUK.
It's really nice to reflect on what you've done in the past. Yeah, and, you know, feel proud of what you've done. Sometimes we don't have these opportunities to have discussions about how we've progressed or how we've done. And it's nice to know that your year has been a good year. Definitely. And you've achieved what you need to achieve. Obviously, there's ups and downs mm-hmm. in anything you go to do. Mm-hmm. But for us, 2019 has been a good year.
Yeah, most definitely.
In so many aspects. It's been really good. If you missed today's show, you can listen back on Spotify and iTunes podcasts. My socials are Facebook TalksHonest, Instagram and Twitter @TalksHonest Show. Good night and God bless.